Ball fielded at the 5 and carried out to the 25, where the Wildcats will begin their first drive. Gale hands it off to Peterson. Carried forward for about 6 yards. Tackled by Coronel. Peterson carries to the 36, and that's good for an Eastmont first down, tackled by Moses Spurrier. Gale's pass intended for Ruffins, incomplete, second down. Pass complete to Ruffins, met immediately by Spurrier. Ball caught at the 45, third and short. Big run by Peterson, 15-yard carry down to the 40. Tackled by Cunningham and a host of cadets. Cunningham makes the tackle in the backfield for a short loss.
Push him back!
Flag on the play.
Hey,
holding penalty will move the Wildcats back. Second and long. Gale rolls to his left, intended for Ruffins, penalty on the play. Indication is holding. Eisenhower declines the penalty. Third down. Gale's pass, intended for number 10, Jace Cavado, incomplete, fourth down. Punting for the Wildcats is Luke Gale, returning for the Cadets, Judah Oldenkamp. Gale's punt takes quite the roll and makes it all the way down inside the 1 yard line where the Cadets will begin their first drive. Oldenkamp takes it himself, moves the ball forward, 3 yards, 7-7. Oldenkamp rifles it to tight end, Caleb Cornell. Pass is complete for 4 yards. Third and three. Slant intended for Cornell, incomplete, fourth down. Cornell's kick rolls down to the Eisenhower 47, where the Wildcats will take over. Peterson runs it up the left side, makes a couple of cadets miss. Finally pushed out of bounds at the 28-yard line by Shoshone Justice. Number 24, Julian Cortez, carries the ball forward for six, second and four. Ball carried right up in the middle, down to the 16, first down Eastmont. Fields pass and turn it for Ruffins, in and out of the hands of Woldenkamp, second down. Peterson carries for four. Down by four of cadets. Third and six. Cortez rumbles forward and takes it over the goal line for an Eastmont touchdown. Peppermint's kick is low, but good. With 4:53 left in the first quarter, your score is Cadets 0, Wildcats 7. Aaron Escalero will kick for the Wildcats. Demetrius Corver back to return for the Cadets. Corporate fields the ball at the 5, returns it to the 12, where the Cadet offense will take over. Holden Camp is sacked by number 9, Skylar Bryant. Second and 17. Pass intended for Corbray. Incomplete. Third down. Holden Camp's pass, intended for number 3, Aaron Culler. Incomplete. 4th and 17. Cornell's kick rolls down to the 33-yard line. Peterson up the middle, breaks the tackle of Sun, brought down by Spurrier. It's a 13-yard gain, and that'll be another first down for Eastmont. Thank you. Running back takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Eastmont. Pepperman's kick is good. With 3 minutes and 11 seconds left in the first quarter, your scores, Cadets 0, Wildcats 14. I'll start Eastmont. Kick will be redone. Escalar's kick sails into the end zone for a touchback. Eisenhower will start the drive on their own 20-yard line. Sartain, met in the backfield by Bryant for a 4-yard loss. Second and 14. Camp calls his own number and finds a big hole. Runs it down to the 34-yard line for an Eisenhower first down. Holden Cam keeps it again. Short game. Second and 7. Sartain runs it up the middle, pushes the pile forward for 3 yards, 3rd and 4. Sartain carries it forward for 1 yard. 4th and 2. At the end of the first quarter of play, your score, Cadets 0, Wildcats 14. Holden call, Holden camp stretches. And that effort is good enough for an Eisenhower first down. Holden Camp fires downfield and finds Aaron Puller for the huge catch.
hurt.
Holden Camp sacked in the backfield by number 90, Tyson Gonzalez. We'll set up second and long. Holden Camp evades the pressure. Throws the ball to Corbray. Incomplete. Third down. Holden Camp moves it forward for a couple. It'll be 4th and 12. And it looks like the Cadets are going to go for it. Holden Camp looking for Corbray in the end zone. Pass is incomplete. Turnover on downs. Eastmont will take over on the 16-yard line. Peterson carries it down to the 38. Pushed out of bounds by Color. First down, Eastmont. Peterson carries it for about 5 yards. Tackled by Corbray. Pass intended for Peterson, incomplete, 35. Pass complete by Jackson West. Shakes off Holden Camp by ground by Spurrier. It'll be 4th and 1.
Demetrius.
Here's Corbray with the huge stop and the turnover on downs. And with that defensive effort, the cadet offense will take over on the Eastmont 46. Sartain runs it up the gut for 3 yards, 2nd and 7. Camp runs it up the middle for 4 yards, 3rd and 3. It's a big man interception as the senior, number 92, Connor Frazier, picks off Oldenkamp's pass. The Eastmont offense will take over on their own 43-yard line. Tony Justice and Heriberto Herrera provide the pressure. Corbray on the coverage, passes incomplete, 2nd down.
Good job, let's go! Let's go!
And that's Shoshone Justice with the tackle for a loss. Third and 12. And that's going to be a holding penalty on Eisenhower. Pass interference on the Ike defense. Automatic Eastmont first down. Peterson carries the ball to the 32 for an Eastmont first down. Met and forced out of bounds by number 17, Easton Green, and 33, Eddie Herrera. Landon Moore carries the ball to the 20-yard line for another Eastmont first down. Peterson carries it for five. It'll be second and five. Peterson carries it for 6 yards to the 9. First and goal, Eastmont. Peterson's carry good for 7 yards down to the 2-yard line, second and goal. Timeout, Eisenhower. He was in just short of the goal line. We third in inches. Indication that Eastmont was not set. That'll move the ball back. Remain third down. Thank you.
Holding.
Moore takes it into the end zone, but holding called on Eastmont. Referee marks it off at the 15-yard line. It'll be third and goal. Pass intended for Ruffin. Incomplete. But a late flag on the play. Pass interference on the Cadets. Be half the distance to the goal. Ball spotted on the Cadet 8-yard line. Gale's pass to Trevano is complete for another Eastmont touchdown. Pepperman's kick is good. And with 2:31 left in the second quarter, your score is Cadets 0, Eastmont 21. Escalar will kick. Corbett will receive. Corbett takes it at the one, returns it to the 23. Flag on the play. Boundary is on Eisenhower. Moves the ball back to the 10-yard, where the cadet offense will take the 10-yard line, where the cadet offense will take over. Camp to color. 35 yard pass down to the 45 yard line. There is a flag on the play. Foul is pass interference on Eastmont. Penalty is declined. First and 10, Eisenhower. Holding camp stop in the backfield. No gain on the play. Timeout, Eastmont. Holdenkamp passes it out to Spurrier. Takes the ball to the 45-yard line, and another Eisenhower first down. Sartain has a lane and moves it to the 37-yard line. Second and short. Holdenkamp takes the handoff to Sartain, takes it himself down the left side, down to the 18-yard line, and another Eisenhower first down. Timeout, Eisenhower. Oldenkamp fires it to Spurrier. Incomplete pass, second down. Eastmont brings the pressure, and Oldenkamp throws it away. Third and 10. Snap is mishandled. The ball is recovered by number 99 of Eastmont, Ricky Falunga. Eastmont will take over on their own 24-yard line. Fields pass intended for more, incomplete, second down. Shoshone Justice brings the pressure. Gale throws it away. Third and 10. Timeout Eastmont. Gale's pass complete for Ruffins, pushed out by Cornell. And that brings us to halftime. Headed into the second half, your score, Cadets 0, Wildcats 21. Fans, at this time, if you would welcome to the field the Ike Cheer Squad and the Ike Cheer Mini Cadets. Give it up for your cadet cheer and mini cheer. Up next, we welcome to the field the cadet marching band. Congratulations are in order to the cadet band for winning first place overall at the Music in Motion at Mariner High School in Everett, Washington. This is the first time the cadet band has won a sweepstakes trophy in school history. But wait, there's more. They also won Best Music, Best Visual, and were the People's Choice Award. We are so proud of our 2023 marching band members, and remember, you can catch them right here tomorrow at the Harvest Festival of Bands. The Cadet Marching Band is under the direction of Chloe Pierce and Jeremy Fries, Visual Design Coordinator Tyler Jones, Marching Instructor Colby Arnold, Color Guard Coordinator Haley Atkinson, Color Guard Assistant Christian Fausto, Flute Instructor Andrea Adello, Clarinet Instructor Francisco Gonzalez, Saxophone Instructor Kaylin Crowner, High Brass Instructor Colby Arnold, Low Brass Instructor Brad Dawson, Percussion Coordinator Miranda Wojciechowski, Front Ensemble Instructor Andrew Button. The Cadet Marching Band's 2023 program is titled All the Lonely People, with music selections including Eleanor Rigby by Cody Fry, Come Together by The Beatles and Gary Clark Jr., I Hear a Symphony by Cody Fry, To Build a Home by the Cinematic Orchestra, arranged by Jeff Chambers, and sound design by Tim Michie. Drum majors, is your band ready? You may take the field for halftime performance. Your cadet marching band. Okay, for real this time, give it up for your cadet marching band! Thank you.
Is that Sean on there?
Yeah. Should be Sean.
Yeah, sure. I was like, yeah. I wasn't sure. Yeah, Sean, come back, bro. I'm nuts. I need you. I need you in my life. Oh, what did Ryan say to you?
As we get ready for the second half, a reminder that tonight's game is conducted under the rules and regulations of the WIAA. Spectators are to remain off the field at all times, and comments of a harassing, sexual, or racial nature are prohibited and will result in your removal from the stadium.
Yeah, we're calling plays. It's our game. It's not your game. That's why Javi was like, I'm like, Javi's our game. Well, like, you only have 13 guys on. It's our game. He's like,
the Cadets will receive the ball to begin the second half. Escalara will kick. And Corbray will return for the Cadets.
Hey, so to be clear, for the senior game, that's a freshman game.
Escalara's kick to the end zone. Touchback. Cadet offense will take over on their own 20-yard line. Olden Camp's carry up the 30-yard line, or 25-yard line, excuse me. Good for 5 yards, and second and five. John Marcus Cunningham carries the ball, stiff arms the defender, and takes it to the 31, and that's good for an Eisenhower first down. Olden Camp on the carry. Three-yard gain, second and seven. Cunningham's carry. Good for 1 yard. Third and six. Holman Camp's pass is picked off and taken to the house by the Eastmont defense for a touchdown. Like this one is coming back. Holding indicated on Eastmont. The interception stands, and the Wildcats take over on the 45-yard line. Gale passes to Ruffins. Catch is good for 7 yards. Brought down by the corner, Larry Dolliff. Pearson carries for 2 to the 36-yard line. It'll be 3rd and 1. Gale sneaks the ball, met by Justice and Cornell. Moves the ball to the 34-yard line, and that gives Eastmont a first down. Julian Cortez carries the ball for a first down, brought down by number 17, Easton Green. Thank you. Ball's carried forward. For an 8-yard gain, tackled by Mejia. In the second and two. Gale throws it away. Flag on the play. The call is holding on Eastmont. He moves the ball back to the 26-yard line. It'll be second and 12. Gale targets Ruffins in the end zone. Incomplete, covered by Oldenkamp. Third down. Gale's pass is complete. Receiver steps out of bounds. It'll be fourth down. Peterson carries it down to the six, and that's good for an Eastmont first down. Touchdown, Eastmont. Ruffman's extra point is good. With 5:59 left in the third quarter, the score is Cadets 0, Wildcats 28. Corbin will return again for the Cadets. Whoever fields the ball at the 2 yard line. Carries it to the 23. Where the Cadet offense will take over. Offensive line gives Oldenkamp room to run. And he takes it out to the 30-yard line for an 8-yard gain. Oldenkamp carries it to the 37, and that's good for another Eisenhower first down. First and Sartain's carry. Good for 5 yards. Second and five. Sartain up the middle again to the 48-yard line. And that's going to be good for another Eisenhower first down. Sartain on the line of scrimmage, stopped for no gain, second and 10. Oldenkamp follows his blocker and finds a lot of room to run. down to the Eastmont 33, and another Eisenhower first down. Holmkamp's pass is a little low, but Demi Cordray's got it, and he carries the ball. Not to about the 22-yard line. Sertan on the carry. It's going to be third and inches. Holmkamp keeps it. And moves it just enough. That'll be good for another Eisenhower first down. Holmkamp's pass, tipped by Bryant, intended for Cornell. Second down. John Marcus Cunningham carries it up the middle for a few. Actually, no gain, third and 10. At the end of the third quarter, the score is Cadets 0, Eastmont 28. Thank you. Marcus Cunningham. Carries the ball close to the line of game. It's going to be 4th and 2. Camp completes the pass to Corbray, and he takes it down to the 4-yard line for another Eisenhower first down. Camp fires at the back of the end zone, looking for Corbray. Incomplete. 2nd and goal. Camp keeps it himself. No gain on the carry. 3rd down. Camp carries it to the 2, and it's going to be 4th down, touchdown or bust. Camp hurried on the play. Forward pass to John Marcus Cunningham, incomplete. Eastmont will take over on downs. Peterson carries it to the 9-yard line. Tackled by number 2, Caden Sun. Cortez carries it for the first down, tackled by Corbray. Gale throws it deep to Travato. Double covered by Sartain and Culler. Second and 10. Peterson carries it before, brought down by Green and Justice. Third and 6. Ferry stop for no gain. Corbray back to return. Punt rolls out of bounds at the 38-yard line, where the cadet offense will begin their drive. The Eisenhower Cadets would once again like to thank the football sponsors, including JJ's Beer Area and Antojitos, Drew Harris of Heritage Real Estate Group, Peachtree Retirement Center, Yakima Federal, Great Forest, Halfback Development, Yakima Junior Cadets, Marcos Ramos of Berkshire Hathaway, Wildflower Body Piercing and Tattoo, Poor Boys Auto Wrecking, Tactical Tag, and Canyon Blooms Pedals for Patients. Thank you once again to our sponsors. Sartain finds some room to run. Steps out at the 48-yard line. And it'll be second and inches. And now they're moving the chains. That's an Eisenhower first down. Sartain again to the 50-yard line. The second and 8. Sunshine Scary is good for 1 yard. 3rd and 7. Ball comes out, recovered to midfield by Eastmont. Peterson carries it to the 40. Met by Green, Corber and Company. 2nd and 8. Also Eastmont, 5-yard penalty, 2nd and 6. And that's Caleb Cornell in the backfield. Tackle for a loss by Cornell. Makes it 3rd and 8. Moore takes it down the sideline. More than good enough for a first down. Flag on the field. Indication is holding on Eastmont. Move it back, make it 3rd and 13. Gale's pass is complete, and John Marcus Cunningham brings the runner down, and it's going to be 4th down. And we have a flag on the field. Personal foul on Eastmont. That will bring the ball back to their 40-yard line. And make it 4th and 20. Corbett back to return for the Cadets. Gale's kick out of bounds at the 30-yard line, where the Cadets will take over for one more drive. Back to Sartain. No gain on the play. Holden Kent again to the 35-yard line. Make it 3rd and 5. Holmkamp passes the ball to Caden's son. He carries it for a first down. There's a flag on the play. Personal foul on Eastmont. That'll add 15 yards to the end of the pass. Timeout Eastmont. Skylar Bryant takes down Oldenkamp. Ball comes out. However, Eisenhower retains possession of the ball, 2nd and 12. Friends, we thank you all for coming out tonight. We ask that you please pick up after yourselves and make sure the stands around you are clean before you leave. Have a great night and drive home safely. You have one shot.
Thank you. Thank you.